Greetings, Pograms. RDS here, back with another video, and I'm really, really late on this one, but today, I'm going to give my view on Ben-Hur, the new 2016 reboot, or as I like to call these reboot movies that are coming out, refux, you know, because most of them have not been good, especially the ones that I really liked as a child have been pretty shit, you know what I mean? Just kind of call it as it is. But yes, Ben-Hur came out in 1959, which I think was a remake from another version of Ben-Hur. It's a novel that was, I think it was written back in the 1800s. Like, it's been around for a while, the novel Ben-Hur. And it's very, if you've never seen the 1959 one, it's very religious toned. I shouldn't say very, that's a strong word, but it does have religious tones to it. And that's not a bad thing. I think it's a good thing, where regardless of your views on religion and God and all that stuff, I think it's good, and it doesn't beat you over the head with it. It doesn't preach at all. So much so that I don't even remember that in the old 1959 one. And I went to go see this new one with my father because he introduced me and my brothers to that movie when we were kids, and he saw it when he was a kid because, you know, my dad's like ancient. And so, you know, it kind of had like a, you know, nostalgic kind of, you know, we're kind of watching this together. Like, he saw the original one when he was a kid and he showed us, and then now we're watching this one, you know, while I'm an adult and he's a lot older. And so it was cool. So Ben-Hur basically is a story about two brothers, which resonates very, people who know me personally, resonates very, very close to my heart, just because I've got two older brothers, and, you know, family issues, of course. And, you know, so it resonates very close to my heart, but it's about two brothers, and basically one brother is a prince. And this takes place in Jerusalem and Rome and all that, like that part of the world, and that's where a lot of the religious tones come from, real deep rooted in that. And, you know, Rome and Romans and stuff had their own gods, they believed in their own gods, and, you know, the Jewish believed, you know, in their God and Christ and all that stuff. So there's that. And then, you know, so one brother is, you know, Ben-Hur obviously is Jewish, and, you know, he's like a prince in his community and all that stuff, and in his village and all that, and, you know, he's basically royalty, and they take on an adopted boy who's, you know, he's Roman, and he is, he's Roman, and, you know, as they're growing up or whatever, like, his brother basically kind of comes to the realization that since he's Roman, he does not want to be, he doesn't feel wanted, I guess, like, Masala, I believe is his name. Yeah, Masala. He doesn't feel like he should belong there. Like, you know, and his stepmother, or his adopted mother, Ben-Hur's mother, kind of doesn't like him, and he's kind of fallen, I guess, would essentially be his sister. You know, but he's adopted, so there's no blood relation. But they kind of like each other, right? Like, they kind of make that apparent. But, you know, she doesn't want them to be together because, you know, he's Roman and she's Jewish, you know. So it kind of brings up that whole, basically, racism, you know, basically, and you know, stereotypes and stuff like this, that, and the other. Like, in the beginning of the movie, Ben-Hur and Masala are riding in horses. They're racing each other, and Ben-Hur gets hurt. You know, he falls off his horse, and he carries Ben-Hur back to the village or back to their home or whatever, their palace. And, you know, this story has been told quite a few times in different ways, like, you know, kind of like the King of Egypt type stuff, you know, where it's two brothers, one's adopted, one's an Egyptian, and one's, you know, like, it's been told before, in a different way, I guess. But this one is like I said, it kind of brings that up. And I think the movie now is a good time with all the crazy shit going on in world today. So yeah, he gets hurt, and you know, he brings him home, and like, you know, his mom's like, "What did you do?" She's blaming Masala, and he's like, "We're riding." His horse threw him off, like it was an accident. We were racing. We were, you know, being young. And you know, she's like, "Just pray for him." So he prays for him the Roman way, and you know, she's like, "You know, we pray to a different god." Like, you know, they set that up very quick, you know. And the original Ben-Hur 1959 movie, it's a very long movie, but it's really, really story-driven. Very dialogue-heavy, very little action. There's only two things I really recall from the original movie, which was where Ben-Hur's on the boat. The guy's drumming, the Roman dude's drumming. They're on this, like, Roman battle boat. And, like, the guy's like, you know, doom, doom, doom. It's a very famous scene. Because I guess the actors that were all the stunt doubles and stuff, like, they really rode this boat, so it was like a really big thing back then. It was a practical effect, so I guess it was a big thing back then. And then obviously the chariot race, which were the two showcases of this movie yet again. So you know, he gets hurt, you know, and Masalas is basically kind of casted out regardless, you know, that the whole time. So he just like, he's like, "Fuck it, I'm leaving. I'm gonna go fight for the Romans," because like this is during like wartime. The Romans are like, you know, invading everybody. So that happens. You know, Ben-Hur recovers, and you know, there's like the heretics basically who are like trying to fight back, but you know, they're viewed as just like criminals, right? Like the Romans treat them like just filth, and even though like the Romans invaded their country and like took them out, basically almost annihilated them, actually almost, I think it was genocide if I'm not mistaken. So you know, that happens, and then like I said, Masala leaves, and you know, Ben-Hur is like, you know, he winds up falling in love with like a maid, and they didn't really like make, I was kind of surprised, and it was kind of a welcome decision. They didn't really focus on Ben-Hur's love interest as much as I would have assumed they would, because that's like the Hollywood formula, right? Like, love. It's always like, you know, love between two people, you know, the opposite sex type thing. Like, it's very rare. Like, that's why, like, Frozen was such a big deal, right? Because it was, like, sister love. And it wasn't just, like, man-on-guy love or, like, you know, the standard, basically. So they didn't really focus on that. Like, you know, they kind of made it a small point. Like, you know, she's a maid and you're a prince. Like, blah, blah, blah. But then it was like, yeah, whatever. Like, he wanted her, period. So they got married, and you know, Masala comes back to, he comes back home, or back to, you know, where Ben-Hur and all them are in Jerusalem, I guess, I'm assuming. I can't recall. and he asks if, you know, if they can pass through there, you know, unscathed, you know, like with protection of the city or whatever, because you know, there's people trying to kill Caesar and blah 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 blah. And you know, so he's like, you know, yeah. So they come through, and there's a scene that happens before where like Ben-Hur's sister is like kind of rolling with the heretics or whatever, trying to help them out in some way, and Ben-Hur like heals one. He helps him out, he mends him back, like he gets wounded and he heals him or whatever, and he stays staying with them. And I guess the kid saw his opportunity to try and kill Caesar, and basically Ben-Hur gets accused and his family, and then all the shit goes downhill, and basically Masala just kind of blames them for being dumb fucks, essentially, even though it's just him being blinded by like just being, just hatred, really, just being blind hated. The hate, basically hate spawns hate, right? Like that's what happens today, right? So you know, Masala's just like angry, a hateful person, and I wish they would have focused in on that a little bit more. It almost felt like it was kind of pushed towards the end of the movie, like, you know, he's inevitably the bad guy, even though like Ben-Hur kind of seemed like a douchebag. Like they both seemed like they were douchebags at one point, and I thought that was interesting, but it didn't really play out the way I think I would have liked it to play out. So it happens, and then Ben-Hur gets accused, and he gets basically banished and punished, and he's put on this boat, and he's basically a slave for the Roman army, and you know, he basically is a lone survivor on this boat, and it gets crashed, and it blows up and catches on fire, and he survives barely, and then what's his name? Morgan Freeman's character shows up or saves Ben-Hur. I can't remember his name, Dirium or something like that. He saves Ben-Hur basically and gets him back to health, and Ben-Hur kind of proves himself that he's like, he can help him with his horses because one of his horses was sick, and he mends the horse, and then he shows Dirium that, hey, I can ride horses too, I'm really good, because, you know, in the beginning of the movie I was racing, so I'm really good. And, you know, Dirium's character is African, and, you know, they're all about money and shit, so he's just like, oh, if you race for me in the chariots, like, we'll make a lot of money, and then you can prove to your brother that you're better than him, and blah, 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 blah. And, like, Ben-Hur kind of becomes obsessed with, like, stopping Masala, or, like, you know, basically proving that he's better than him on some level. So that kind of loses its steam a little bit for me. I don't really care about the whole competitive aspect of we as people. But the other message that's there, because they show Jesus. Now, that's where a lot of the religious tones, like, they kind of sneak it in there. There's a part where, like, you know, you kind of assume it's him. You see a carpenter, and he kind of gives, like, Ben-Hur, like, he kind of gives him, like, a message, like, you know, love is the key. Like, love is key to everything. Like, love will conquer all, basically. And it was, like, real quick scene, and then, like, he moves on. Like, he's working on a table or whatever. So you're like, you know, hey, that's Jesus, right? And the guy that got for him, I think he had a really good look. He wasn't, like, overbearing. He wasn't, like, super Jesus face. And, you know the guy I'm talking about. Everybody has a friend where he's got, like, the really long hair and the beard, and you look like you're the embodiment of Jesus. At least how he's depicted in, you know, the Bible or whatever, in pictures and paintings. So anyways, the guy they picked, he looked really good, you know, and I thought he did a really good job. And then there's a scene where Ben-Hur is like, he falls down, he's exhausted, he needs water, and Jesus basically rescues him. Like, there's like a Roman soldier about to whip him, Ben-Hur or whatever, and he basically calms everybody, and he grabs water, and he gives him the water, and he's like, you know, why are you doing this? And he's like, and then Jesus is like, you know, you would do the same for me, and blah, 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 blah. Like, you know, and everybody's just kind of like, you know what I mean? And it's a really good scene. I really loved it. You know what I mean? Just kind of giving you that taste of, you know, that the power of love, you know, that power of compassion. And it was really good. Like I said, it wasn't overdone. It didn't, like, destroy the movie. So then as the movie goes on, basically Ben-Hur learns how to ride on a chariot, and he learns all these techniques, and, like, Dirium is telling him, like, things that happen, like, you know, they're building up, they do, like, a little montage, basically, of him, like, getting better on the chariot, and how to, like, basically how to drift on a chariot, essentially, and all this, and he's learning different tactics, like, you know, basically survive, you know, until there's just you and your brother, like, everybody will kill themselves, you know, and then when it's just you and your brother, then you beat your brother. So it's kind of like survival, basically, like, be the last man standing, like, don't be the first one to die. So there was like a good little message there. So that happens. The chariot race was freaking amazing. I was on the edge of my seat, even though, you know, I knew what happens, you know what's going to happen, but it's so intense, and it's done very, very well. Really good camera shots. The action's pretty, you know, it feels impactful. So I really got into it, and people who know me, you know what I was doing in that theater, like, but, you know, so that chariot happens, and Ben-Hur wins, and, you know, everybody's, like, celebrating, and, you know, blah, 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 you know, and then they show Jesus getting killed, they show him getting crucified, and, like, Ben-Hur tries to, like, give him water, but he gets whipped and stuff, and he's about to, like, hit the guard with a rock, and then Jesus is like, no, I give my life up willingly, and blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, awesome, you know. And those scenes really got me. Like, I'm not, like, a true, like, you know, I don't go to church and stuff every Sunday. I'm not, like, a holy goer in a sense, but, you know, faith always gets me. It's always something about it, especially when it's, like, an undertone. It strikes me really powerful when it's, like, subtle faith, and those scenes really, really got me. So basically, you know, he dies, you know, Jesus dies, and then Ben-Hur is like, you know, I lost my brother, like, I'm an idiot, like I lost my chance, like I've been so hell bent on like getting back at him that I didn't realize, like, you know, I should have been trying to save him. And then there's a scene where he like comes out and like he is alive. You think he's dead, but he's not. Like he's knocked out, I guess, but you see his lifeless body when Ben-Hur wins the race. Like they're picking up like Masala's body, and he's just like, you know, you assume he's dead, but like he starts yelling at Ben-Hur, and he's like, you know, I have hate in my bones. I have hate that'll last me an eternity, and I won't stop. Look what you've done to me. Like, you took my leg. Like, his leg's missing. And he's like, look what you've done to me. Like, blah, 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 blah. And, like, I hate you. And he's so angry. And, like, that actor did such a good job convincing me that he was fucking angry. Like, I was just I'm in this theater just like, because it's so convincing how angry he was at this moment. Like, you know, he pulls out a knife, and like Ben-Hur's getting closer to him, and you're just like fuck, man. And Ben-Hur's like, I'm sorry, brother. Like, I'm sorry I did this. Is like, just like, you know, you carried me when I was hurt. That's all I can do for you is carry you. I'll carry you forever. Like, and they hug each other, and I die. Like, I seriously die. It still chokes me up right now, just kind of giving it to you now. And it's such a good scene, and it's really, you know, and you know. Morgan Freeman's character comes out and starts narrating. He's talking about the power of love and family and just forgiving, you know what I mean, no matter what, and that's what we're here to do. And it's a really good message, and I think people need to hear it, you know what I mean, in this day and age. And I know the people who need to hear it probably will never hear it, and whoever watches this video, I hope this makes you want to go see that movie in some form of fashion. Like I said, the message is amazing. So, but yeah, I really liked the movie. I give it a thumbs up, even though it's a reboot. It was done very, very well. There was a couple of moments, a couple of things I would have done a little bit differently. But, you know, for a new audience, I think it did an extremely good job that are going to watch it. It's going to be a younger audience. And then, you know, there was a lot of old people in that theater, and they were like, oh yeah, I remember seeing, you know, the old one back when I was a kid. Like, it's crazy, you know, but, you know, blah, blah, blah. And that's kind of cool to see that, you know. And you know, my dad said he liked it, but, you know, unfortunately, he likes everything. It's very rare he doesn't like a movie, but he really liked it. I enjoyed it. Like I said, if you were on the fence about seeing the movie, or if you don't know anything about the movie, I say go see it. And hopefully I haven't spoiled too much of it by giving you the synopsis, basically. So if you've seen Ben-Hur, the new remake, and if you've seen the old one, what did you like between the two movies? Like I said, the only things I can really remember are the boat and the chariot race from the original, because I haven't rewatched the original in a long time. It's a long movie to get through. It's like 3 hours long. So, so what did you like about the movies? Let's talk about it. Let's talk about Ben-Hur's. Like I said, I really like both movies. Obviously, two different movies, and I'm really surprised that they did want to remake this movie, because it won so many awards even back then. Like, it was a really well told story. It was a very strong story, and I'm pretty sure this one won't win anything, unfortunately, because, you know, it's a Hollywood movie. Unfortunately, it wasn't done with a lot of care and heart. It had some, like I said, the message is really strong. I'm probably giving a confused message here, but I recommend to go see it with some loved ones, if you have some relatives that you're not too keen on, you know what I mean. You know, I think the message is strong enough. You know, make up, you know, get over whatever it is, and, you know, be a family, because they could be gone and you're gonna regret it. So that's all I got for y'all on that one. Sorry to end on a bad note, but hey, it's a good message. Love conquers all. Love will triumph. I do believe that, even to this day, even though I'm very cynical a lot of the times, in my personal life, but I do believe that love is the curator to all. So, as always, keep gaming, watch some movies, let's talk about Ben-Hur, and I'll catch y'all on the next one. Like, subscribe, comment, and I love y'all. Always.